I would like to thank everyone that's involved, everyone that participated, and everyone that just got to enjoy this event for what it really was, bringing the community together.
I appreciate every single person that is contributing to this.
From the bottom of our hearts. Thank you.
Welcome back. We got a special one today. It's a onesie party. There's gonna be a pillow fight. I'm gonna bring in my guests on here today. I'm pretty stoked to be here. We got Stella Achenbach. I'm gonna fix it quick. You don't need to move yourself. There we go. And we got pizza. So
what's up, y'all?
How you guys doing?
Doing great, man. I feel like I'm giant on the screen right now, and you guys are teeny tiny.
It's all good. We want to see you anyway, so that works.
I want that to change. I don't want to be giant.
Wait. I can help with that. Look.
There you go. That's the one I always want to do, right? I just like drop myself in from the top here. I'm gonna leave the screen, then I'll come back.
That was always the idea, yeah. We had this once, no? We thought like flying in would be a cool thing, but then we were like, maybe it's not as cool as we think it is.
It'd be cooler if we animated it rather than
having to manual do it manually. Dragging.
Yeah. True. But no, so this one's going to be cool. So we're inside. Oh, help me out, Pete. It's Hubla's house. Yes.
Yeah,
I think Hubla. I nailed it. And this is really cool. The collection is the onesie party collection from Moonwalker. There's pillows. The pillows are awesome. They fling feathers when you take a swing. So I'm hoping to make it to round two, but Pete, you and I are facing each other round one, so.
Yep, it's going to be good. I'm excited.
Stella, I don't know who your opponent is yet, but it's going to be exciting.
Yeah, I'm already afraid, but I pulled out this wonderful random looper on level 25 that will hopefully, you know, be up for the challenge. I don't know.
I think, I bet Moonwalker Pete probably announces in-game as we're going here. Oh, there we go. Let's see how this works. Okay.
Here we go.
I'm going to move this around.
I feel like I look a little bit better on the screen. I was just obsessed with how giant my face was. Okay. I feel a little bit better. Here we go.
Hold on. I'm going to move you around a bit until we find one that works.
Okay. Ooh. So we're going to be using my screen for the kind of main screen.
I like that. That works for me. Then we're all off on the side, not too giant. I'll put myself back where I'm somewhere around.
Yeah, you should just make yourself bigger.
I'm really little.
Come on, just make yourself.
You are tiny girl.
Do this so we're all the same size.
There we go. I like it.
Yeah.
That works.
That's unnerving on my right side because I'm huge. But
I like it.
Oh, is this round one? Okay. I'm going to turn names back on, Pete, so I can talk through who's going.
Okay, that sounds good. I have names on if mine's the main
thing. I think that's good for this one so people know who is fighting.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
I'm totally cool with that.
So, Beardy just entered.
Here.
I saved this background just for this moment. You see, I've had this in the background with the 8-bit coins. I've been planning ahead.
Yeah, look, it looks nice.
We need eventually a bricks background.
There we go. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so good. There's my thought for ranged weapons, Stella. Thrown bricks. That's where I'm going.
Okay.
I'm excited. I actually have a short destroyer that I want to donate to the winner of tonight. I'll share it. I'll pull it up here in a minute.
Oh, Stella, yeah. I don't know if you knew that. There are prizes up for grabs.
Wait, what?
Yeah, so we donated a layer-up onion, and then Bitcoin donated another NFT that we're doing through the ones he gave to layer-up. So layer-up and Bitcoin are donating a large round-headed cat NFT. And then I know there's other – I can go through the prizes here. Let me see.
I'm probably not the only one who missed out on this. I have a feeling.
Yeah, I think this one, I think a lot of the announcing for this one has been inside of Moonwalker's Discord. So,
okay.
But either way, it's going to be a good time.
I'm in the Discord right now. Are they in general chat? Is that where?
Let's see. Yeah, okay. So he's going in game. So Rip and Travis are up first. We got to get a ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble. I'm not going to do the committed one, Pete. I can't do it.
I know. I want to. But I'm just, yeah, I can't commit right now.
Yeah, so Stella, I peeked inside of Pete's map. I had to peek because I didn't go in.
It's okay.
I haven't ran around yet. I haven't ran around without you yet. So that's Pete. We were waiting. I wanted to go like day one, but I wanted to get Stella in there with me on Friday. So
I betrayed your trust. I already went inside.
Oh,
and
did
I
you
killed
go?
Them.
Okay. Wow.
That makes me feel some bugs. Some fleas. Some fleas.
The late fleas.
It's really just fleas at the moment. We have not opened the doors to the blockbuster yet. But Stella, what do you know about the map? And
I have absolutely no idea. I only went around a little bit. I killed some fleas. I collected some popcorn. And then I was like, I shouldn't be doing this. And then I was killing some more fleas, collecting some more popcorn, finding some energy drinks. And then I was like, no, I shouldn't be doing this. I should get out of here.
No, you know what? When you came back, I had a full sprite sheet. So I think that's okay.
Right?
Yeah.
You owed me one in a way.
I did. I really did.
Because he was like, yeah, I'm going to wait for you. And then next time we're on, he's like, well, I don't really have like a full sprite sheet worked out. And I'm like, what?
I became obsessed. I'm sorry.
It's easy though. I was also feeling this after our last stream. I was like,
Oh, Frame Boy and Stella.
When do you think you'll
We're
have
not
your...
paying attention?
Stella? Oh.
Oh, what?
Okay. What's happening?
I think
Stella, you're up. Okay.
Numa and Brain Boy.
Oh, not me. Okay.
That's my fault.
Sorry, I said that twice. Numa is Brain Boy, so.
Oh, Stella and Brain Boy, you guys are up. Okay.
There's so many names that I have to learn, like back and forth between the Discord
chat. Okay.
It's awesome.
Fight me! Come on, where are you? There's only a kitty cat. Oh, Shame is Brain Boy? No.
Brain Boy's over in the corner over here. Level one, Stella. You're gonna be brutal.
Come on, Brain Boy.
Where is
Come
Brain?
On.
over here on the side.
I see.
Oh my god, he's hiding. He's like, I can't do this.
This is our GM right here.
Yeah, that's our
level
GM.
5 avatar. Where's your onesie, Stella? Is that you in the...
She came in in heavy.
I'm really mean doing this, but I could not also fight. I'm sorry. This one
is deleted. we'll have to share the GIF that
Brain Boy
sent us for your fight.
Wait, was that did that fight already happen?
Yeah, she hit him twice and he disappeared.
Oh, okay. I didn't even see him. I have to admit, I did terrible camera work. Right there. Anyone that was watching this stream.
You need the 7.4K cam one.
I know. I do.
Matt is in the chat. Hello, Matt. Hello, Cozy Boy 09.
All right. So Stella wins the first one. What's your username?
My username? Arendelle Chateau, but I guess it should be the other way around. It should be Stella and then maybe something else.
Oh, I like
but
it.
Well, it's Arendelle Chateau.
Work call. GM was working.
Oh, okay. No.
Travis versus Rip.
All free to play will be reset tomorrow. So they changed on me again. So Travis is my cup.
Ah, okay.
Wait, how do you know? How do you know who's up against who?
So Moonwalker's announcing it.
Oh, okay. Got you. Come at me, Parody. Level 64. Grunk.
Oh. Stop running, Beardy. I know my level 3 pillow is scary.
Oh my god.
Got scared? You guys scared?
I was scared. I ran away. We can't do that one yet. We're fighting each other first. I'll come back. Oh, you want me to throw real quick? Well, I'll leave it be. Because my face is huge right now and I don't want to take up the whole entire screen. There we go.
Okay, so who's up next?
Okay.
I probably should pay attention to chat, huh? Okay.
Yeah.
At least. Hold on. Should I do it? But I'm not in the Moonwalker Discord.
Let's see.
Not prepared.
Well, they're announcing. Okay, there you go. Me and Beardy. He's level 1.
Okay, Moonwalker versus Beardy. I love that crown that Moonwalker has on.
That was the quickest thing.
Is that even allowed?
You know, it happened. Oh my gosh. That was amazing. That was fantastic. He just looked at him and he was gone. Let me find this bracket. I don't even know what's going on. I'm going to go back up to this bracket.
Yeah, where's the bracket?
So the bracket is in the Pillow Fight channel.
Oh, there's a Pillow Fight channel. There it is. Okay. I completely missed that. Okay, so I guess we're up, Gronk.
Are we? Okay.
You ready for this?
Is it us? Let's see.
I think it's us. It's Moonwalker and Beardy just went. We're next on the bracket, I think.
Moonwalker's like, oh yeah, I'm getting out of here. Grunk! Do it!
All right, you call it, Pete.
I'm ready when you are.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
I'm going to zig and zag all over the place. You got to get in and get out.
What level is your pillow?
It's a 3.
Oh, mine's a 3. Good game, Gronk.
GG's, Pete.
Good game. I guess I'm out of the tournament.
I tell you, well, no, hey, so do you know who I fight in the next one?
Elimination or what?
No, I think it's single, and I fight, I'm pretty sure I fight Beardy next.
Oh. What do you know? What level is his or was his?
His pillow? I don't know, but he's
not in his.
Well, he's holding the pillow, and I think he's going to run with that one. So it is what it is.
Does he have
your kitty?
Your kitty.
I love your wife's duck outfit. The thing looks awesome.
Is she in here now?
There. Yeah, she's talking to the kitty cat. Oh, I thought I disappeared. She's trying to get the cat out of the ring. The cat was in danger. Okay, so let's see. I'll pop this
He's
up.
Gonna
so,
fight Alex.
So Moonwalker is fighting Beardy as level 1.
So. Oh, that's going to be a quick one.
Didn't they already do their fight? Or are they doing it again?
I'm not sure. Let's see. Beardy is in the ring. We just got to drop the.
Ding, ding, ding.
Someone ring the bell.
That Oracle. There we go. Oracle versus Treasury. Treasury's at 8 already.
So, Stella, you're going to fight the winner of MCB and Hoobla.
Okay. Yeah, go Oracle.
The problem was she zigged when she said it should have zagged there.
That's exactly the problem.
These little loopers are so cute.
The ones that are cute.
I'm kind of scared of that gold pillow now. It's full of bricks. Gold bricks.
You will show up on Friday having like figured out 20 brick sprites, isn't it?
I don't know. We'll see. I got some ideas. It just honestly, it's like that's like the story of my life, right? Where I'm like, I go down that rogue path and I'm like, I'm going to commit. We'll go. We're just going to make them brick by brick.
But you know what I really like about the pillows is this like glow or sheen around some of them. Like mine has this like kind of like glow effect.
Yeah, no, that thing looks awesome. I think Nex's looks like that too. It's kind of got like a kind of purple haze around it.
Yeah. It's similar to that. I like that. Something to remember. Good technique.
Oh, this one's going to be... This one's gonna go. Yeah, Beardy's so scary standing in there. I think we're missing Travis.
Did he go out?
I don't think we've seen him in here yet.
Oh, maybe he's.
So it's Beardy and. No, Beardy Moonwalker. Who's up? Am I up?
I'm not up. I'm out. I'm cameraman at this point. Oh, are we all shaking our butts?
I'm going to run. Hey, watch this tactic. I'm going to run away from Beardy the whole time. He's not going to catch me. I'm just going to waste his time.
Wait, you have to fight against Beardy?
I think
right
I have
now?
To fight Beardy right now. It's on the bracket. So Beardy fought Moonwalker. If this is the current bracket...
Yes, I fought Rainbow, yes. Oh, thanks for answering.
Sorry, the fingers were already on the keys. I was like locked.
Yeah, no, you're always fast with the chat. I'm super slow.
Yeah.
I'm snail.
So that means you fight Beardy. Oracle brothers here. Nex, gotta buy. Looks like Smiley and Nex. Who's up? Okay, you guys are playing. Okay, let me fix my screen.
You can do it. You can do it.
Good luck, Gronk.
You can do it.
There's 3 damage. This is rude. This is rude. Beardy. It's like I'm hitting him with a real pillow.
Run, run, run.
He's just messing with me. It's a 205. It's a 205.
Did it spread blood when he just killed you? It looked like little
the
blood
number,
droplets.
The number was so big. Covered up like my whole body.
I think we already know who's gonna win this tournament, isn't it?
I think we might already know. I'm not sure anyone stands a chance. I think we've got this in the bag at this point. But it will be interesting to see who wins like this battle. This one will be interesting. I mean, this one will be close. Oh, wait. Is it not Smiley versus Rip?
Let's see. So
Get the cat out of the ring. Get out of there. I don't know the cat's name, but
you were like, this seems like a fair fight for once.
Oh, okay. So money's on next. Next has a
Oh no. I'm sorry.
Listen to me.
Okay, the cat's out. The cat's out of the ring.
It's good to go.
Done.
Robits, thank you. I already lost to Beardy. He looked at me and I died. But I appreciate the support.
Okay, so
I did my best.
Beardy wins his.
Well, so you got two sides of this bracket, so they're not bouncing around too well.
So
man, some people got some buys because that bracket didn't get filled in on that side.
Stella won hers.
33 what? This pillow's not a 33. Is that what I just read?
So it'd be Stella versus Rip?
That's for real?
Is that right? Okay, sorry.
That's just mean, but it's okay. Come on, little Teddy. Come on.
Brother was somewhere.
We lost our, you know what? Should I give this some audio feed in the background here since we lost our game music?
Oh, yeah.
Let's do that. We'll give it a little, let's find out what indie rock is.
What the hell?
Be better about showing our chat on screen too. I need to do that. This is someone needs to take charge here. I'm gonna start announcing.
You're gonna start announcing what?
Yeah. Who's up?
That's what I'm gonna do.
Okay.
I'm not sure. Let's see. Well, so if you're in there right now, you should be fighting Travis or Hoobla, but they're not here.
Oh no.
So
Hoobla is here as Rip, right?
Oh, okay, yeah.
Aren't they the same? Okay, so Rip should be in. So Rip versus Stella, is that right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, so yeah.
Okay. Rip v Stella, let's do this.
Oh,
take those people out, Stella, really quick.
Yeah, get them. Get Treasury. Treasury killed me 3 times in a row in the Gladiator Arena. I need this revenge. I'll take it.
It's done. I took care of it.
Thank you. So, this will be good. Smiley's got a higher level pillow, but Stella's got a higher level looper.
Yeah.
I'm interested to see how the math goes here. I think you got
your health, Stella. How's your health right now?
Yeah, it's good.
Her name's still green. I think she's in business.
Yeah. Is Smiley's pillow that high?
Hey, Smiley's going down. He's yellow. Yeah. I don't know what his... I know. So I don't know if I read this correctly. Oh, you got him.
Oh, get him. Finish him.
One more finish.
There you go.
Fatality.
This will be a once in a lifetime opportunity, I guess. You will never let me do this again.
I was waiting for one of those.
I like golden pillow charms.
It's full of golden bricks. Okay, so now.
Pillow.
Who should I actually fight against? Because
you know what
I don't.
I'm gonna do. I'm gonna write this down and pay attention because I'm gonna fill this bracket out as we go with real paper.
Yeah,
imagine that.
Do this. Someone needs.
Imagine that. Okay.
Wait. Wasn't
okay,
I supposed
to? That wasn't an actual battle. I don't think that wasn't.
No, it was.
No,
just...
no. You're supposed to fight Rip and Tear.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was like Super Bowl halftime.
I like it.
We didn't do like the actual battle. I think it's Rip and Tear, no?
Yeah, that's who you should be fighting. Who's in charge of the show?
Oh, there's a voice
chat. There you go. You got him. Are they in voice chat in the Discord?
It looks like it. There's Beardy, Moonwalker, Ribbentair, Smiley, and Treasury are all in voice channel.
I could pump that in here, but that could be chaos.
But it could also be super fun. Yeah. You want to try?
We could try it.
But do we have to?
Should we ask him before I put him out live?
Yeah, maybe. Here, yeah.
Yeah.
I wonder if maybe. I could jump in.
Here, you know,
okay, yeah. I can jump in the chat without joining it.
Okay, yeah, just type in their chat. Because I could join that and we could hear everybody.
And then it went quiet because everyone was so focused on the chat in game.
Yeah, right.
Sorry.
That was like weird. I'm telling you. That's why I put that background music on. And that's why we did it the other day when we were doing pixels.
Pete, I think we just really, really need voice chat in game.
We really do. We really, it really needs to happen at some point. I think we'll figure it out someday. I agree. I think for events like this, we need something like in game where it all can just like be broadcast inside the game. That would be awesome.
Yeah.
So are they there in the LooperLands voice chat? Oh yeah, they're all in there.
Yeah, I pinged them in the little chat for their voice and asked if they wanted to. There are two people that are unmuted, but it doesn't look like anyone's talking.
Okay.
How can they not chat while doing this?
I could join and see.
Well, if you join, it's going to... Well, actually, I don't know. I don't know how you'd have that set up on your end.
I got to get back to the other Discord real quick. Okay.
Someone needs to battle. I'll come in and I'll fight you, Stella. That's what we're doing.
I'm coming okay.
So it was Stella versus Rip. It could also be Beardy beat Grunk. We could just say Rip forfeits and Stella goes against Beardy. That would be next. Next beats Smiley. And Treasury. It would be Treasury versus Brother if Brother's around.
Everyone, I said I lost a Beardy and Smiley goes, everyone will.
It's true. It's very true.
He's not wrong.
I'm leveling up.
it's a light breeze on his back. That's all he's feeling.
He's like, oh,
wait,
look
oh,
at
wait,
all
I prepared for this. Hold on. Ready?
Yeah.
I got one of these.
Ooh, nice. We need to add a clapping emoji. This is like prayer hands, but... It's meant to be a clap. Okay, so who's up?
I think Stella is fighting Beardy right now, but he's just sitting there. Oh, no.
Oh, man.
Okay, so Beardy beats Stella.
He just let the fight last a little longer.
So Beardy is in the final four. I mean, I guess he kind of beat everyone on this side, right? So Beardy's in the championship.
I mean...
Wait... Am I not in the championship? Are you serious, Pete?
So I think you honestly
you fought hard, but I don't think you made it.
Wait, let's see. So you went. So there.
Oh, you win.
And you had to.
Beardy won.
So Stella you were sitting Stella like.
Beardy. So
I think you're in the runnings for a prize, though.
But to be absolutely fair, I think Beardy and I are cheaters anyway. Because we were not using a onesie.
I almost brought in my, once I saw you do that, I almost brought in my Demi, but I decided not to.
Like on this side, is that the best camera angle?
But I leveled up my weapon, so that's nice. I leveled up my pillow.
Nice.
Yeah, this actually, I think the big benefit of this whole event was I got out and leveled up my pillow to level 3, which is like needed. I like having, like my weapons are all very low level. I really want a high level ranged weapon, because I know we're eventually going to have like wars and stuff.
That would be really fun.
Yeah.
That sounds awesome. On map catapult. That's my vote.
Oh my God. That'd be amazing.
Like you can man the catapult. Oh dude. Do like active tower wars, but you have to actually shoot them. Oh yeah. Man.
Yes. Sign me up for that.
It'd be so in. Well, all of a sudden LooperLands will be sectioned off into factions.
Yeah, right. Gonna happen. It's
the LooperLand Wars of 2025.
Wait, did you see this? I won.
Nice. Who was in there?
Here's my cup.
Yeah, it was my cup. Wait, yeah.
Is he back? I think his name was Cup.
Yeah, that was MCB.
He was can I change my character? Awesome.
We should have had brackets for like different levels. I think Pete, that's something else. Like, is there, I know you can disable traits inside. Oh man. All right. I'll go die again.
Oh no. No. Don't you go again?
You know, you can't catch me. Oh my gosh, I tried to get away. I was doing pretty good. You cut the angle off. Python, run away.
I think it needs to be Beardy versus Nex for the championship.
I did my best. I just want you all to know I did my best.
You indeed did. We saw it. We witnessed it. We can confirm.
Hit me with that pillow and I disappeared. Beardy versus Nex. We're at the ship already, huh?
I think so.
I think we should have anyone like level 5 and under battle royale at the same time. Beardy and Stella are up. All right, we're going back.
Okay, my bad.
I guess we were trying to push it forward. Again? And I don't think they were ready for us.
You already killed me so many times.
I guess we can pay attention to Moon in chat for now.
It's good.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
Discourteous, unprofessional.
Woo! Very soon. Here you go.
That 64 is no joke. That is no joke.
Yeah, I want to know like what his health is at when he's fighting all of us.
He probably lost one.
Yeah.
That would be funny, though, to have us all take him on in there, but then we're all hitting each other, too, bouncing off like pinball. Yeah.
But you know what would be cool is if you manage to actually run away, right?
Like a timer?
Yeah, you regenerate like a lot faster. And then you actually have a chance, right? If you actually would have a chance, I think it would make it even more exciting. Because otherwise you're like, oh, it's a 64, like no one will ever, right? But imagine someone's like really, you know, nifty with hitting the keys. They could,
I'm stealing that because that's one of my favorite things I've ever heard. Nifty with hitting the keys. I love it. I'm stealing that one. I love that. It was fantastic. Anybody ask me if I'm good from now on, I'm going to say I'm nifty with hitting the keys.
What do you do?
I'm so in. I love it.
You know,
No, that's spot on.
Right?
I really like it. I really like it. Yeah. I'm not exaggerating. I'm a big fan. Like, no exaggerations. I really like that. All right. So here, the other one too, though, that I was thinking, it's like, what if you could disable levels, period, inside one of these PvP zones?
See, that's what I want to do. That's what I like, just for,
because then it wouldn't matter, right?
Just like, boom, flattens everything.
Mm-hmm.
That's and I know we do like the rentals. Just walk in.
Yeah, like I felt like the Nancy fights were pretty evenly matched because we were all right there.
Exactly. Yeah.
So that was a matter of, and I was feeling really nifty with the keys that day. So I was feeling good.
Wait, did you win? You beat me like five times.
I was like, I went like, I think I went undefeated.
Yeah.
It was, if you could hear my keyboard when I was doing that, it would have been embarrassing because I was smashing the keys.
You were very nifty.
I was going full nifty.
So I do wonder, like, if there is like some sort of tournament manager that you could do for events like this, where you could pop it up on screen and you just enter who won and will automatically do it, so it just shows people visually where we're at.
Stella, that's like over bunched and stuff. Those are some of my favorite things, like 100%. I'll say them for years.
I don't want to feel overbunched. I want to carry everything.
Everything, all the loot, Pete. We want all the loot. We don't have enough coins. Oh, Pete,
gold do you have? I have one gold coin so far.
I have like 300 split across a couple loopers.
Where do you find gold? I've found like one by killing rats and crabs and goblins.
Oh, I haven't gotten a drop like that. So in the chests that are hidden about through the map,
yeah,
that's where we were finding them. My first one, I got really lucky and got a 50, and then Stella got a couple tens.
Wait, what?
On the coins, when we were looking for coins.
Oh, right. Yeah. But we also discovered a lot of like poofs, right?
Yes.
A lot of like, mm-hmm, empty spots.
So, oh wait, we have to ask though, Pete, what's up with the rat in the cage? I want to know what that's for, because we tried to use it and it didn't do anything. And we spawned a rat.
Yeah, we spawned a rat, but because I didn't think that would be it, I actually killed the formerly caged rat myself.
Yeah,
which
was
so dumb. But what's it going to supposed to do?
You don't know about the rat? Okay.
Tell me about the rat in the cage.
So you can buy a rat in a cage.
Yeah.
For, I think it's for 85 coins, and it's like got some text with it that makes me think that I need to go down a rabbit hole and find out what it's for. So all I want to know is if there is something that I can find and do, because if there is, I will hunt it for days.
If you're having that question, that there's a rabbit hole to fall.
Okay. Out. Well, then I will rabbit hole.
I am venturing to guess, and who knows, this could be a DeGroot rabbit hole. That's my guess, because he's the one that's working on this. But there is a team that has been working on the shops. So I don't know who all is working on it. So that is a rabbit hole that's, I would just pull that thread a little bit and see what you can find.
All right, I'm pulling on it. Well, I will go hard.
This is the cage rat. Look at this. Like, can you see it on my screen? I don't know. Maybe it's too tiny.
Oh, there you go. Or we can throw. Let's watch this. You're about to be huge, though.
Oh my god! Yeah. God. Now I'm
surprised. So there's the caged rat right there. Can you read the text again?
Did you buy one? Yeah. What's the text?
So it says, the caged rat is a peculiar offering found in several shops and markets where it serves as an unconventional commodity with a variety of potential uses. Captured alive and housed within a sturdy cage, this rat is a testament to resourcefulness and ingenuity. Whether employed as a curious pet, a source of companionship in lonely travels, or even as a component in arcane rituals and alchemical experiments, the caged rat offers a versatile solution to those seeking unconventional solutions to their needs.
Wow. Tell me you don't want to pull on that strand.
Right? So how much is it?
I think
it's 85. Should I get another one?
You have enough for another one?
Yeah.
Oh, I you got all the coins last time.
But I'm spending it on research. So it's
I mean,
okay,
hey,
right?
I will. I'm telling you, I'm ready to dive down that. I will go.
Okay, so here's the thing, right? So just to actually, can I release it from in here? Because then we will know.
Go,
for sure.
Go put it in the ring.
Go
put it in the ring.
No one's gonna see it. Oh, maybe. Yeah, you're right. Let's go.
Let's. Hey, maybe it's. Oh, maybe it's the anti. It's beardy kryptonite.
Ooh.
Oh, that'd be pretty funny. I would enjoy that.
Wait. First, I have to find my way back. I'm still bad on like the what?
Who are so you? So you're gonna go back up to OA, and then so go right there.
Oh. This one, right?
Yep. Perfect.
Bit by bit. Okay. And then... Wait, no. Yeah. Right? I'm in the right town. Am I?
Yep.
Well. Let's but where see. Do I need to go?
Up and then to the left. That house on your left. There you go.
There you go.
That was tough. Okay. That screen's tiny that I'm looking at over there.
Okay, I'm in here. So I'm gonna uncage the rat, okay?
Okay.
Are you guys ready?
I'm ready.
There. But the problem is, if someone hits
the
rat...
Did you drop a rat somewhere?
Oh, they killed it!
Next!
So do you have two?
That was amazing. He walked up and just smashed. No rats in the house.
Just invest the 85 coins into the cage rat.
I told you, you owe him 85 coins. He owes you 85 coins.
Oh, that was short-lived.
That was amazing.
Oh, we tried.
I'm kind of, I'm pretty excited it released it in here, though. All right. It's a twerking sharky.
Wait, where were we at with the battle? What's good?
I don't know. Beardy wants to know what the cage rat does, and if he doesn't know, then we really gotta find it. That poor rat. Pea stained pillow. Jeez. I was wondering if that's what that was, and it is. That's interesting. Poor rat. Poor rat. Next is the one who hit it, though, Pete.
Next is the one who said that.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. It's passing blame. It wasn't me.
Once you uncage it, can you re-cage it?
No, I don't know.
No.
No, we let it out. Last time she killed it herself, and that was kind of funny.
But to be fair, we were on the map, and it seemed like just a bunch of rats around
us. It did look like a rat just kind of spawned. And...
Yeah. And then I was just like, wait, did I just kill my rat?
I'm gonna deep dive into finding rats or using the caged rat. I'm going to spend like all these coins on 85 a piece caged rat. How many coins do you have? None. I spent them on rats. Well done. Well done. I'm coming back in. Let's go.
Let's go.
You can't catch me.
I can.
Oh, I like that.
I'm going to juke you. Hold on.
Uh-oh.
I had no chance.
Oh, now Smiley's coming in here too. Come on, guys. Come on, guys.
Where are we at? Where are we with the bracket?
I think we're waiting on brother. So let's see. Okay. Where's brother at in this bracket? So, okay, so that's the bottom right corner is brother, and it just says open spot. So I don't know if that's been updated or not. Oh, that's a melee in there. I want a piece.
I'm trying.
That's just pure chaos.
But I'm dying now.
That's because Beardy's in there, and he's probably got a.
This is a real pillow.
Oh, bag. Beardy ran away. What do you? Beardy's hurt, and he ran away.
Someone had to run away.
No, I stayed till I died. I'm not afraid. It's all dead out of here. Uh-oh.
Oh, wait. Wrong home.
No,
where's the right home?
Let's see. I'm frozen.
Oh, I'm back at Din's house.
I'm going to bring my Dimmy back.
Man, I never know where I am.
Uh-oh. I think, let's see. Are you still your level 25 looper? Because the one I had in my inventory went down to a 1.
I still? What do you mean?
So I had that in my inventory too, the free-to-play that was a 25. And it went back down to a 1 in my inventory.
Oh, no.
I think Smiley took it away.
Yeah.
Oh, nope, you're still at 25. You're good to go.
Yeah, I can still go. Okay, hey. Who's next? Who wants to go?
Ready to go. Hey, Pete, you think Bertle's seen this turtle onesie yet?
I don't.
There's I'll tell you what. If yeah, so Beardy is in the turtle onesie.
Oh.
Level 20. He's got that thing to a 20 already.
Jeez.
Oh, really, guys? Come on. So mean. I saw a onesie that's like a black widow.
Oh yeah.
I like this one.
There's some really good ones.
There are.
I'm bummed I missed the Spider-Man one.
It's also good, yeah.
I don't know who has that one. Oh, okay. Updated bracket in general chat.
I'm surprised that anyone still kept track of what we were doing here.
Yeah, I have no idea what's going on right now. Let's see.
In general chat. In LooperLands?
Oh, probably, yeah, because it's not in the onesie party general.
Okay.
Okay, I got it. There we go. There's my death. So other side, so you're waiting on brother and treasurer Alex right now is what we're waiting on.
Okay. So Beardy's in the final. Okay, brother, treasurer Alex.
I guess I could just chill out here. And I'm like, I've been dead for a while, so.
Yeah, I'm just.
Mike, I'm going in.
I'm cameraman.
You going in?
Let's go. You're not going to catch me this time. No. No.
I got you.
The gold pillow is no joke.
The gold pillow is great. Actually, maybe Beardy wants to go another round. Oh, Beardy changed his looper.
Oh, yeah, you might. Yeah. Call him out. There we go. All right, get him in there. Beardy doesn't want it. Beardy doesn't want the golden pillow. Let's switch this up. We're gonna go. Let's see. Nature sounds. There's some funny ones in here. Yeah, it's supposed to be Treasury and Brother right now.
Treasury isn't there.
But I think Brother is not coming.
Okay, so I think my cup is fighting for Brother, maybe.
It looks like it.
Well, this is going to be close.
Yeah. It's a good battle. Is now on my cup's pillow. Is that a...
That's what he said. He said, get hit with the pea stain pillow. That's
okay.
What he said. That is what it is. I was gonna ask, but I didn't. So, but I'm glad he said it because I didn't want to say it out loud before he said it. I didn't want to be that guy.
Death by pillow.
Hey. You want to do a pillow fight too?
Everybody wants in on the pillow fight.
Be like, what are you even doing? I don't understand.
Pete, I like your pillow. It looks awesome. It's no golden pillow, but
yeah, it looks like good. It's covered in blood.
It was because you used it in the ring. That's my blood.
Yeah,
that's my blood.
It's actually my blood. I just cleaned up myself.
Yeah, wiped yourself off with the pillow.
Tears in my own blood on the pillow.
It happens. It's all good.
This is a short destroyer, an official one from my collection that I'm in right now that I'll be putting in the auction for this coming up Sunday.
Ooh. Is this one? This one's not a dev auction, right?
Right. It is okay. Not a dev auction.
Okay.
So I don't know when we're going to do the next dev auction. I need to talk to Smiley about that, but
I think Smiley said March.
March.
Yeah. Because I was thinking we'd do, I was thinking about doing the Grunk Onion in there for the dev auction.
Ooh, that's a good idea. That's a really good idea.
This music is slowing me down here. Let's go. We'll go back to this one. There's some weird chimes going in the background. And I couldn't tell if it was coming from the music or if it was coming from the... I'm going to have to... You know what? There's... Sorry, go ahead, Pete.
Did Treasury beat my cup? Well, I guess...
You know, I don't know. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Get him. It's close. I think his pillow is a higher level. Oh, so close.
You destroyed me.
No, you got him close. He was hurting. I think his pillow was level up. He was hurting. Yeah, see, I'm telling you. Steal that one.
Always going in the wrong direction here, aren't I?
You go to the right or you go down?
Oh.
It's on the left above the house that is Din's. So let's see if you go. I'll come find you.
Oh man. I always get lost.
Oh yeah, you go. I see you. So go up.
Oh, this I just have right to here. Go to the left. Okay, now I got it for next time. Sorry. Thank you.
No
Thank
problem.
You for picking me up.
No problem at all. All right, here's what I want to do. I want to like make a background check album and just mint that for my own usage. The music thing's always rough in the background for anything we do that's not like in-game music.
That's nice. It's always chill. Works.
No, it's fun. It's fun to sit and hang out and not have to like keep track of everything that's going on.
Yeah. So what just happened? Did Beardy beat?
So Beardy's supposed to be fighting Nex.
I think they just fought.
Was that immortality? Yeah. I think there you go.
The final? Was that the final?
I think so.
Wait. What we just did?
I that think the what they just did was the final.
Oh. Well, I definitely lost.
A little bit zoned out. I was like, wait, yeah. What's happening? Okay. I think it was the final.
Yeah. I feel like we're like halfway out of the loop here.
Yeah.
Trying to keep up, I swear.
You know, since there are like a few different rings now, the pillow fight ring, right? And then the one on the, damn, what's the name? Like this really cool, like Roman inspired.
The Colosseum. Yeah.
Colosseum. Thank you. Mm-hmm. And probably like other people would want to build something similar, right? It might make sense to have like a leaderboard that just shows these things.
That would be really cool.
We already have a player versus player board.
So let's see if I can find that one again.
See if you can pull that one up. Although we do need one for things like this, I think. And maybe that's like a creator, like per creator thing for each of their worlds.
It sounds like, Stella, we need to do our own fight night or something. Yes.
Yeah,
I want to figure out how to make it so everybody gets the same level though when we go in the ring.
We need to talk to Smiley. This is something that we need to definitely bring up because it's something I've wanted for a while too. Because if we can even out the levels, that just makes it
pure skill.
Exactly, that just makes it fun. And you were dominating the other night, so I want to know what you were doing.
I was breaking my keyboard. That's what I was doing. I was rolling hard.
Remember what you just wanted to steal from me.
Oh yeah, sorry, I was getting nifty on the keys.
That one,
there we go. Yeah. I went full nifty.
Full nifty. Head on the keys,
nifty on the keys. The title track of our new album, Stella.
I like it.
I'm not joking. There it is. I already got three songs laid down. The first one's Nifty on the Keys now.
Oh, I love it. Okay, cool.
I need to wash that thing. I got hit with the pee pillow. Gross.
Another thing we need is like a live chat role. Because when I pull up chat like it is, can you see my screen?
Yeah.
It doesn't do it live, like as someone comments.
No, yeah. So you have to exit back out and go back in.
But yeah. It'd be nice because the way Ordinary Adam has this house set up, we got the ring right here and I could have the chat going right here.
That'd be cool.
It'd be a pretty nice little view.
Yeah, absolutely. I was thinking the same thing that, you know, if you anyway have this much black space, I mean, I guess, you know, be it the leaderboard or the chat is almost like widgets, right? Or if they would work like widgets where you can like position them essentially where you need them to be, that would probably be ideal, you know?
There's plenty of games out there like that. Time. Yeah, there's plenty of games though where you get to choose where the chat shows up. So, I mean, it's definitely a useful thing. Like I know certain games I want it like in top left or other ones I want top right. So
yeah,
pretty cool. Yeah.
In my wish list.
I don't know. I say though, if you're going to do something like this where you have a bracket, I think the coolest thing to do would be to like cancel out levels period once they enter the ring.
Absolutely. Yeah. Especially when there are like real prizes on the line.
That's the thing. Yeah. There's prizes on the line.
Yeah.
Yeah,
we're lucky Jack Straw didn't show up too.
I know, right? But yeah, I think that would be the best thing to do. Then you start getting into like, it's just skill, it's esport at that point.
All right, I got a cut. Oh, sorry, go ahead. I had an idea, but I'll wait. Sorry, it just popped in the head.
I was gonna say, but once we start getting, we need more collection wars so that Beardy can be on like, you know, multiple sides. Level up a specific collection like the onesies, and then onesies go against robots in some kind of war on map. That's where I think the levels can come into play, and you don't really know who's gonna win because you can kind of even things out with a big crowd.
Even them out with getting nifty on the keys.
Exactly. I think big wars are gonna be a lot of fun because one thing you can do is you can basically, as a creator, you can make a space where you can basically switch the door on and off. So you can let everyone in, divide them up, you know, have everyone dispersed basically, you know, one this side on this side, you know, robots on this side, onesies on this side,
I was going to say, buy asset.
If they die, they can't get back into the arena, and it's just the last avatar standing at that point.
That is awesome. And I love that.
That would be a lot of fun, and I think we should try. Someone should try, and I think I will in the Short Destroyers map at some point.
Catapult.
Do something like that.
I want a catapult. All right. Hey, Pete, I had an idea since we got you here. What if we go check out your map right now?
Let's do it.
I think this is done. I think this is done right now.
I think we are done. You're right. Let's go check it out, and then I'll have to hop off here.
You're good. I just want to peek real quick while we have you here, and you can talk about it, which would be a lot more fun. Don't judge me, but I'm definitely switching loopers for that too.
Yeah, I'm gonna get into my janitor outfit.
I'm gonna put on my my stock associate looper.
Wait, give me a chance. Give me a chance. Wait, I'm coming.
I'll be there waiting. Ooh. Or should we all go in together or what?
We'll go in together, but don't look at my screen because I definitely was already in here.
Okay. I'm looking. Okay. Did you see I added, this is Bill, the guy who's standing out front. This is kind of the Short Destroyer's mascot. His name is Gil. He's Short Destroyer, official Short Destroyer number 35. And it was basically a community member who's just, who was a huge part of the community. It was a fun part of the community. I sent him Gil, and then I ended up, I can't even remember what I did. I think I bought him off of someone, and told, oh no, what I did. Anyway, this is a long story, not that cool. But there's a guy whose name was Paper Hands, because he sold a destroyer coin for 5 LRC. Basically, I think it was the same day that we had an auction for destroyer coin. That in the destroyer coin went for like 500 LRC or something like that.
No.
So he got the nickname Paper Hands. And he was kind of like, you know, it became a joke in all of the discords. This was like before the marketplace opened. And so I sent him, I ended up buying Gil off of someone. I can't remember for how much. I think maybe like 500 LRC. Because I was like, they were selling him. And I was like, you know what? I really want this one. This one, like, because when I was minting them the first time, it was really hard to do. And by the way, I think we're waiting on you, or are you already in there?
I think she's already in there. We're going in.
I didn't know how to get out. To be honest. I just didn't know how to get out. Maybe you guys should show me.
I think it's on the top right.
There you are. Okay. So there's really not much on this map, but I can show you around a little bit. So this is, we're all zombie stock short destroyers, right? The goal here is that you will have, we're going to have a storyline. I'll have my wife probably on the podcast at some point in time to talk more about the storyline. But basically the goal is we're all employees of this Blockbuster. And we got to figure out what's going on. So basically there's this old deserted town in Chicago that's kind of a real town. If you go look it up, it's kind of based on, real life events. And so there was basically this toxic waste spill that drove everyone out. Now it's kind of abandoned. That's kind of what this is based on. So this is like an abandoned Blockbuster from like 2006, I think is the setting that we're in. We all are employees of this Blockbuster who happen to like get infected, and we're still just here showing up to the job, working. That's kind of the setting that you're in right now. What you're trying to do as the zombie is figure out what's actually going on and make your way to the cellar of the Blockbuster. So you'll go in and the game will be played in the parking lot and in the Blockbuster itself. So you'll have like the video aisles. There will be a video game section where you'll be able to play a first look at Loopworm's new game that's coming out, the Michael game, which Grunk, I sent you a little bit of a preview of that as well.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it a lot.
So you'll be able to play that in the video game section in
the Blockbuster. That's phenomenal.
And then you'll have to figure out how to get, you'll have to unlock some doors to get into the basement. I won't share too much about the basement because that's still in production right now. We're still building that part out, but the basement will be kind of like a maze, like one of the cave levels that you see here on LooperLands. And then the cellar will be like a cellar, like a room that you're in, and you'll be fighting the big boss in that room. And that's kind of the goal. Here on in the parking lot, you fight your late fleas. Have you guys seen the giant late flea?
So I have. I peeked at it. Din took me over there, but I don't know if Stella's seen it yet.
Stella,
I've only come to fight the fleas.
Okay, there's a giant late flea. It's a boss for the parking lot. There will be more in the parking lot eventually.
I love this flipped over car, Pete. This thing looks awesome.
That is, I think that came with the royalty-free pack that we had.
I still like it, though. It's
no,
awesome.
Right? It is nice. It is really nice.
Wait.
Let's see.
I'm coming down. But the fleas
funny,
are...
I see you both down here.
The fleas are heavy.
You might need to bring the big guns on this one.
Yeah, I may need to...
Bring out that 25. Yeah, so down here is the big one.
Oh,
yeah, because you can't outrun the fleas.
Okay, no, you can't. Yeah, you can't.
No, the fleas are pretty nasty. They're like, yeah.
It's all right, hold on. I'm bringing in the big guns.
$28 late flea. That's what we tried to do with the late fleas is, you know, they're all different price ranges. It's supposed to look like a late fee.
I love it.
You know, you should offer bug spray.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good. You should be able to buy it.
It's like a boost. Yeah.
Yes. Oh, Stella. I love it.
No problem. Let's get some bug spray.
Stella's bug spray.
You could be even more nifty about stuff. Because you know what I just learned is that all bugs hate the smell of peppermint and eucalyptus.
The eucalyptus, yeah.
Eucalyptus, sorry. Eucalyptus.
No, you're good.
Eucalyptus, yeah.
Oh, I made mine angry.
That could be even something, you know? Like repellent kind
of.
Like.
I know squirrels don't like cinnamon.
So maybe it's a craft your own repellent. You have to find some eucalyptus.
Yeah, or like, you know, one could be repellent, so it gives you like a longer period to survive like flea attacks, right? Or bug attacks. And the other one could be like, you know, actually the spray and just boost your power to destroy them.
Yeah, I like it. I like where your head is, Stella.
Always. See, stuff like this.
Are you thinking about your own world for this game?
Yes, I mean, you know, I'm super slow right now because there's like 1,000 other things that are already started, but
I want to hear more about what your that sprite you were creating the other day.
Yeah, so that's one of the characters, right? And yeah, I think it's gonna play in space. I don't know how to make this into a map. But there's essentially their spaceship, right? Uh-huh. And it's like I figured out I want to two different places already that they should travel to. But it's yeah, it's coming along very slowly.
I love it. That's but very exciting. You should.
Yeah, I think so. I want to do it.
World for it.
Huh?
You should absolutely make a world for it.
Yeah, but you know what? I still don't quite understand how.
I think so. I am in the same shoes that you are in. So one thing that I did was, you know, I worked with actually a pixel artist to create the Short Destroyers collection and basically split it 50-50 with him. Then I ended up taking the other 50 that I had and gave it to the developer. Who can help me work on this game. So I just did a small collection. and then just split things with people, because I want to see my world get built more than I want to make money from it. I can actually compensate some people for actually building it. So there are, you're already working on the pixel art. I think it's a matter of like splitting something 50-50 with one of the community developers to help you get started. That's how I would start. It's getting easier once you kind of get started with it. It starts to become like, I can now like go look at all of the maps, which took me forever to even figure out how to go look at the files of all the maps on the GitHub and like kind of see and pull them up in, we use Tile, which is the program. It's like Pixel Studio or A-Sprite for pixel art. Tiled is for like your map art, essentially, and it connects directly into the game.
How is this called? I'm so curious now.
Tiled.org, I think. Tiled, or it's called mapeditor.org, and the editor is called Tiled, and it's free. It's open source, free map building software. And I think there are some videos online. What I want to do is have some LooperLands specific videos where people are learning Tiled and like kind of building out their map within Tiled.
So this is essentially a game engine for Tiled maps.
This is essentially a game engine. Yes, that's essentially what we're building. Yeah.
Ew. You know, for me, it's really exciting to also do it, but I do need help, developer help, obviously, right?
Well, if you want to do it, I think you have all the tools where you can learn. I would say if you have the time to learn it, and you can do it at your own pace too, right?
Exactly.
with what I've seen, I bet you could auction off like one piece from something on our creator auction that you're making, and I bet you would probably be able to buy your map token for the game off of that one auction. I wouldn't doubt it.
You think so?
That
would be amazing.
I am positive. I would venture to guess. I'll say I'm 90% sure, just to be safe.
Have you seen one of the auctions yet, Stella?
One of the what?
The auctions.
So we do Sunday.
No, I have not yet seen one of the auctions, even though last time I tried to join, but then someone was mean to my calendar, let's just say. But no, when's the next one? Is already one set?
It's Sunday. I think it's going to be one that's a bit bigger than. We've kind of taken the last few weeks off. We had one previously. It was like a week before Sunday. So it's almost a week and a half ago, basically, is when the last one was. This past Sunday, I had to cancel just because things with the map. There was just a lot going on this weekend.
And relate.
But yeah, I can't even imagine Grunk. So this coming Sunday, I guess February, whatever. I don't even know what date that is.
Hold on, I'll get it for you. Because I'm losing track of time too.
And are you, what zone are you in? Stella, are you in Germany?
No, okay. I'm in Peru, in Lima.
Oh, okay. What time zone? How do you know?
It's the same as Eastern Standard Time right now. It's the same time.
Okay. Pete and I are cheating over here in the past. We're both PST.
I know.
Oh no, I died. The fleas.
Those things move fast, Pete. They're no joke.
Yeah.
No, these are heavy.
That was the last second addition to.
I love them. I absolutely love them. Oh no, Stella's surrounded. This one doesn't want to get hit. Get back here. Yeah, no, I'm excited to work on some more stuff. I've been tweaking those sprite sheets too, so it's been really fun to learn all that. Like when you guys first pushed me that way, Pete, I was like, yeah, there's no way I'm pulling that off. Like, No way at all. And now I've been pumping out stuff left and right.
It is a lot easier than you think. And once you get
addicted, it's just really fun.
Yeah. You're hooked. So I actually created a couple of sprite sheets. It's been a while since I've had the time, but now that I've done it, and I think the two of you have gotten me like inspired to start creating sprite sheets again, because it's been so long since I've made my own. And so I'm going to try to, because I haven't made a weapon yet. So I'm going to try to have a ranged weapon for the auction on Sunday.
Oh, nice.
Ooh.
That's going to be exciting.
Pretty, like, when I understood what ranged weapons are, I was like, oh, this is actually really cool, because that means you can actually have a staff and you don't need to, you know, wheel the staff around, but rather it's like, you know, it can be something else, some other kind of movement. That's actually pretty huge. But like, how do you prepare a weapon for being a ranged weapon? Is there something specific we need to like think of or take care of?
So I might be able to share my screen, but basically there is a special sprite sheet for ranged weapons. There's an addition to the weapon sprite sheet. So you have your sprite sheet for a looper, you have your weapon sprite sheet that's a little bit bigger, so it adds the range of motion to your weapon.
Yeah.
And then the ranged weapons, there's one more sprite sheet that's for your ammunition, basically. So what you'll do for a ranged weapon is create the standard weapon sprite sheet. So let's say you wanted to create a bow and arrow. You'll create your sprite sheet for the weapon is the same weapon sprite sheet that we already have, and you'll just make your bow with that weapon. And then your ammunition will be the arrow, and there's a sprite sheet for the arrow. And so what we do is we'll provide the template for those. And so you can go in and basically take the same frame, like what you do with the looper, and just go start to draw out your weapon and then your ammunition, and then you upload both of those to the game.
Oh, got you. Okay.
You know what I heard there, Stella?
Hmm?
I'm going to be able to throw some bricks.
That's right. You were going to be able to throw some bricks.
I'm so down. I want to try. I just want to try at least.
The bricks are going to be great. There's just no way people would love bricks, brick avatars, or even companions.
Yeah, I was like, what's the most ridiculous thing I could make right now since we're sitting here? It's like brick.
So I'm adding this short destroyer, Short Destroyer 235, which is one that I went in and finished the sprite for it, which I'm slowly doing, but I'm adding this one, plus the first weapon that I've ever done is going to be the spear that he's holding. So it's going to be a combination ranged weapon plus this short destroyer, which I think it's going to be fun to see how it does. It's going to, this coming auction, I think, is going to be a lot of fun.
No, I think that's perfect too for your staff that you want to do, Stella. That's going to be huge.
There are different classes. There's like a magic class, a bow and arrow. I can't remember all of the classes. Let me actually pull up my chat with
the group. Makes me kind of want to jump in this again.
I mean, I'm down if you are. Let's just keep this going.
I think what's the next part I need to do, actually?
So each ranged weapon needs to be one of the following classes: bow, gun, or wand. So I think your staff would be a wand.
That's perfect.
The weapon class determines which resources are needed to buy projectiles for that weapon.
Okay.
So when I, like, if I get a wand and it takes like magic, for example, or some sort of, like, you know, you gotta get this crystal and, you know, get magic to be able to create or craft the projectiles.
Yeah.
I have that weapon out, the resources that I'm buying, like if I buy a projectile for a wand, it's just gonna change, the way it looks will change per weapon that you have. So you could have two different, if I have, like, let's just say arrows, for example, in my inventory, if there's a weapon that's like a brick, and you know, someone added the brick as class bow, it's going to show that the bricks in my inventory, it's just going to say arrows, but they'll look like bricks because of what Grunk has drawn on the sprite sheet. Does that make sense? So yeah. It's basically the only difference between bow, gun, and wand are the resources needed to create the projectile for the weapon or the ammunition for the weapon.
You just gave me like five more ideas now, so I will be going further rogue than I did before. I will get nifty with the A sprite. I can't stop with it. I'm just happy somebody else says nifty because I honestly say that all the time. And I'm happy.
It's a good word.
It's a nifty. Great word. It's a great word.
For so many things. It's a good word. Okay. So.
You know what we should try to do?
Pete, do we have a ranged weapon like example sprite to understand this better?
Oh, like the, okay.
There is, there should be in the chat in the, I think it's in the creator one, not 101, but the creator chat in the Discord.
I'll track it down here.
Let me see.
I'll make myself useful since I'm.
Oh, I'm going. I'm already going. I'm going.
Nifty bricks. There you go, Stella.
So this is the creator 101, right?
Yeah. Here, let me tag you really quick.
Okay. And then become a pixel commander, pixel studio, a sprite, general tools. You and
okay, I tagged you. And basically it's just this image. So the image that's shown on screen or in the Discord that I tagged you in. I don't know if you can see it or not. That image is the example sprite, basically. That's the right size and everything that you need for an arrow. Or that's just an arrow example, but you know, if you did, you know,
this is magic. Okay.
So top row is the in flight, and then the bottom row is on impact. I can't tell on your screen or not.
Okay, so,
Does that make sense?
So it's only two rows.
You see.
So for the wand, it will just be like movement on the upper row and then magic on the second row, essentially. And you're like, no, I disagree.
Wait, Pete, you got a thumbs down popping up on your screen.
Really? I'm trying to do this.
That's funny. No, it popped up like a bubble, overlaid. Okay.
I'm trying.
Okay, okay, movement on the upper and magic on the bottom. And you have like five frames each.
Correct. Yes. So basically, the top row is just in flight. So you could make it, you know, bobble up and down, or you can, you know, do. And I don't know what the frame is. I want to say. De Groot said he thinks it's 32 by 32 for that frame for each. So there's, five different frames for that top row, which is the in-flight version of it.
And so for a wand, it would be the same schemata. It would not change, right?
It's the same thing. So you just put like, you know, an orb flying thing that, you know, is covered in magic, you know, flying through the air. And then impacting whenever it hits. That's all you do.
You know what comes in really handy now? Remember when we were checking out the pillows and I was like, I really like if it has like this like semi-transparent beam around it.
Yeah.
That's actually great for the wand. That's or for
absolutely,
the staff.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's a great idea.
And it's like sprinkles. Then it's like Sailor Moon goes crazy. You know?
I love it. Smiley dropped the nifty on us.
Nifty.
Of course. What's he saying? What can we do? Great words.
I'm gonna use it forever. Is what I'm gonna do. I use it all the time, anyways. But now it's gonna be a thing every week. Well, we
get tiles and start. Just have it and start preparing because I want to see you. Live stream building a world. I think that would be a lot of fun.
We can do this, Grunk, can't we?
I'm in. I mean, you're going to have to carry me, but I'm in.
I'm totally going to carry you all the way.
I don't mind getting carried.
You know, for a change, this is because I'm, you know, I do this for a living, right? Not pixel stuff, but like other creative stuff. And, you know, usually you're a lot in a silo working on stuff, right?
Yeah.
And it's so nice to just do stuff and make things together. It's just so much more fun. But the professional world often doesn't really allow for that, you know? Yeah. From like NDAs you have to sign to like ghost designing generally is a big thing, right? And so, yeah, this is just, yeah. This
then is you where played with me and we went rogue.
Yeah, this is, I enjoy that you go rogue because you have this like liberty, you know? I used to say this back to people in university when I was teaching. I was saying, you know, sometimes it's really an advantage if you don't know everything there is to know about a certain discipline, because you can just do stuff and you will not feel like, you know, caged in a way. Yeah. You know, I remember a lot of people who started studying with us were like, had like previously done an education as a tailor, right? And mm-hmm. so then they came into fashion design, which was not necessarily the same requirements as tailoring, like something very neatly, you know? It was about experimental shapes and silhouettes and all of that stuff. And they were just constantly in their own way because they were like, but this is going to be very difficult. It doesn't make much sense. The construction for that, crazy, right? Whilst, you know, there were some people building crazy silhouettes and shapes, right? With just, I want to say construction foam, you know? Yeah. And it looked great. It just looked so amazing afterwards. So I think this is like, you know, so Grunk, don't always feel like, you know, this is not your turf. This is like 100% your turf. You're made for this shit.
I mean, I don't mind going in blind and embarrassing myself, and you all know that, so no big deal. I don't mind at all. It doesn't hurt my feelings. And I'm down to try everything, so let's roll. I'm in.
That's important. That's what we're going to do.
So I want to see Grunk and Stella's world. And Grunk, I know you sent me some stuff like D&D related too.
Oh, yeah, I'm in.
This game is like perfect for some
kind of... Yeah, this really would be.
So I think figuring that out would be a lot of fun. And I think that's something we should dedicate some time to looking into. I need to go look and see what that tool was that you sent.
Oh, I'll send you a link to it. Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah.
It's pretty cool. Yeah. We went down another rabbit hole, Stella. We went down the old Dungeons and Dragons there. So. Yeah.
Of course you did. Of course you did.
I mean, it's funny. Like, so I didn't play that till I was like, 33, I think. I think that's right. But my kids wanted to try it. So we got like a starter set and we started playing. So we've been doing like campaigns with the kids and it's been a blast. Like, speaking of going rogue, they're horrible to DM for. And it's always funny because you make these plans. You make these plans and they just know. Like, this whole backstory for anybody. And they're like, no, they just killed the guy. So, okay. All right, fine. We'll go down the side route.
Now you have to try doing it. We should just play the same, like, campaign right behind you. You go play it with your kids and then come play it with us.
It'd be fun. We test it on them first. Yeah. They make good guinea pigs.
Yeah, exactly.
Because then you get to find out what goes wrong.
So having like Dungeon and Dragons like campaign builds, campaign maps.
Well, so there's I'll show you some stuff. It's really cool. So I got some tools, but as a way to play like through the internet.
Yeah.
You know, like play with your friends and not have to be in the same room and but still have a game board per se. Yeah. And it's even cooler than a game board. So
yeah.
Which it's similar to this, like you could use this like crazy for it.
Yes, I need to go look at it because that would be a lot of fun. I've never played a full, I tried on my, I think it was my 26th birthday, my like a bunch of friends came over and we were like, let's get drunk and play D&D. None of us knew how.
That's when the story goes real sideways. That's what happens.
It did not work. We did not have any clue what we were doing, but I became fascinated with it. And then started watching Critical Role. You guys have ever seen that on YouTube.
You showed me that one. It's pretty cool.
And so I became, you got to have a really good dungeon master, like that knows what they're doing to really get the best experience out. Yeah.
I'm really good on the fly. I'll DM for you, Pete. We'll just wing it. I wing it, but you won't know. I always meant to go that way. I swear. Well, all right. What do you think, guys? About that time?
I think so.
Okay. Well, thank you for sticking around. This was fun. We did the onesie party. That was a blast. Beardy taught us all a valuable lesson that don't get in the ring when someone's a level 64 now, I think.
Yes.
for future, I don't know. Maybe we work one out where it levels everybody out even. But yeah, but it was fun. It was fun. But I think Stella will be back Friday, maybe. We'll adjust on that if we have to. Pete, you're always welcome to pop in and join. I still want to take you through Cyberverse.
Yes, we need to do Cyberverse, and I need to finish the Night King so I can actually do a ways.
Stella, he hasn't got through it yet, so we got to get Pete through through the Night
King. Yeah, and we have to do it. Friday, probably Din will join us again, so our chances are much better with Din than without Din.
I will try on Friday. What time is that? Is that 11 a.m.?
So it's 11 for us.
If you can do an hour earlier, I have an hour. I leave to pick up my daughter at 11 exactly. But if we can do an hour earlier, I have that time completely free.
Can you? Okay, request from my side. Can you do an hour later?
Can I do it? I can. My daughter will be running around. But I'm down to do that.
Bring her in. We'll put my kid in there too. We can bring one of mine in. We'll do a kid.
Mine doesn't have as much of an attention span. She's almost three now. She will sit and say hi, and then she's
that off. Works.
Yeah,
mine just leaves me behind and goes running off. I don't know where they get that at all.
That makes sense.
No idea.
I mean, why don't you honestly, guys? Why don't you do the Friday stream, and I will just join like as a visitor later on, because I actually have. It's not like a surgery, but it's, you know, something where they have to put me down for a bit. So this is why I said like, oh, maybe we need to push it a little bit back, right? I'm happy to just join whenever I can, and you just start an hour earlier.
We'll talk about it and work it out.
Yeah. We don't have to commit right now.
We'll work it out. We got time. We got a little time.
Team, aren't we?
We can't do it without you. You got to be there. So we got to make it work. We got to make it work.
Okay. Fine. Okay.
Cool. All right. Well, until next time, thank you all. This was really fun. Thanks for showing us around your world. I can't wait to see you more.
Thank you for hosting this always, Grunk. It's always very, very well
done. It's a blast. It's always fun. Always fun. But all right. Well, until next time. Thank you all.